You're more than welcome and able to download it to those devices. Leave your Whitecaps email, any official correspondence that the college sends out to your Whitecaps email will be there. If you've never accessed your Whitecaps email, it's your first name dot last name at whitecaps.gc.edu. And if you've accessed your portal and Canvas, it would be that same password. Again, if you've not accessed your portal or Canvas and you need that reset, please give us a call or come by and we can reset that for you. There also may be some issues if you have a like name, like you have a common first name and common last name. We might have multiple students with the same name, so we would need to check to make sure that there's not a number like Jane.Smith1 or Jane.Smith2. But that's something that we can check for you. Your Whitecaps email is very vital that you check it, especially in this area when we have bad weather. That is how the college communicates to students. It should be your primary form of communication between you and your instructors, for the simple reason that, let's say you notified your instructor that you were gonna be out for a few days and requested some additional time to turn in assignments. If you were to send that notification through your Gmail or Yahoo account, we have no way of knowing that it was actually sent. Whereas if your instructor's saying, I never got this email, and you sent it from your Whitecaps, there is some trackability. We could actually go and show the instructor that, yes, this email was sent to you, it was delivered on this day, and that would benefit you to use your Whitecaps email. We try to encourage students to use that as their primary communication. We cannot force you, but just know that we could help you a little bit more if you use the Whitecaps email versus your personal email. Do y'all have any questions regarding the Office 365 or any access into the portal? Have you been able to log in to the portal? Okay. Now, once you're in the portal, you do realize that there is all the other functionality that's there for you, where you can view your unofficial transcripts, you can view your class schedules, you can go in and register for classes. You can also, I believe, remove classes. If at any time you need to go and print your syllabus or your unofficial transcripts, let's say you need to turn that in for whatever reason, again, in R120, which is the service desk, you have the ability to log into the computers there and print to our big copier there. If you need to print your class information from Canvas, you're more than welcome to come in and use those computers. We do have a color copier where you can print your data. There is no real charge for you. You are allotted, I believe it's $2.50 per day for printing. But if you require additional money for printing, you can just tell us there at the service desk and we will add additional funds to your account. We can increase the money that you have. There is no physical transaction of money. It's just you tell us that you need more money on your account, we'll add it for you. So this is what the sign-in screen would look like to log into your Whitecaps email. would look like once you've logged in. And I know some of the instructors, if you notice, there's something called Teams that the instructors are going to try to start using this coming semester. It's a way for them to communicate with you as a student without having to send each student an email. What the teacher's going to do is create, let's say there's English 1301, he's going to create a team for 1301 and your section number. And he's going to add each individual student into that team. That way you can communicate, you can send messages to your instructor. If he asks for you to participate in a discussion, there's also ways that within the team that you can upload files. For example, let's say your teacher asked you to do a survey and he wants everybody to upload it so that y'all can share the data. You would just log into your team, upload your file, and everybody in your class would have access to it. It's also helpful for if you have a question about a particular item in your class, maybe another student could respond and give you some information on how they were able to resolve the issue that you presented. It is a very handy feature. Teams is also available as an app to download on your phone if at whatever point your teacher does decide that they want to start using Teams. There is also an app for Outlook that you can install and associate your Whitecaps email. That way you always have your email and you will have access to your any pertinent emails that come through regarding class cancellation or any communication from the college. One of the other features that's available is the Office applications, which is Word, Excel, PowerPoint. OneDrive is where you would save all your files. And let's say you created a Word document, an Excel file, and then you go save it on your OneDrive. When you log into a computer here on the campus, you have the ability to connect your OneDrive. So that alleviates you having to carry around a flash drive with your files. They're all going to be right there and accessible to you wherever you log in. Do you have any questions regarding any of the applications? SharePoint, we are not really using that functionality right now. If your teacher would like to use that, that's something that they could set up with each of you. But primarily the OneDrive and Teams is what one of the functionalities in your Outlook are the primary functionalities that we use of the Office 365. Again, if you see in the upper right-hand corner where it says Install Office, that's where you would go to install it on your local computer if you wanted to. There, as I stated earlier, there's really not a need to because it is a cloud-based application. So it would save space on your computer if you don't have a very big hard drive or a lot of memory on your computer. So it is there for you if you choose to use it. You do know that how you access all your grades to view your transcripts from the portal. As I stated, if you have any problems with your account that you cannot log in, or if in Canvas, if you're not able to see any of your data, we can try to help you with that to make sure that everything is visible. There are some troubleshooting that we could do to help you, but as far as your account, we can make sure that everything is working for you so that you can get your assignments in and access any applications that you need to assist you in that. So, if you don't have any more questions, I believe that's pretty much all the functionality of the portal and Office 365. And again, like I said, we're located in R120 on the first floor of Regents. you have any problems, just feel free to drop by at any time. And if you have need assistance connecting any of your personal devices to the Wi-Fi so that you can access these resources, we'll be glad to help you with that as well. We are not allowed for legal reasons to work on your devices, but we can try to help you connect so that you can access the resources that we provide to you. Okay. Thank you.